Brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of Mary. She was chosen by God through a special grace to be free from original sin. All of us, meron po tayong tinatawag na original sin because of the sin of Adam and Eve. But Mary, since she was chosen as the vessel of the Son of God, she was free from original sin. So, it also takes the cooperation of Mary into this plan of salvation of God. That's why when the time came, Archangel Gabriel came over her when she was in a state of prayer to tell her the plan of God. Ang maganda doon, sinabi ni Mama Mary that sabi niya na let it be done unto me according to your word. That was the most beautiful answer that Mary has answered through Gabriel. Kasi nung sinabi ni Gabriel yung plano, parang imposible kay Mama Mary. But nung sinabi ni Gabriel na walang imposible sa Diyos, nothing is impossible with God. So be it, sabi ni Mama Mary. Let it be done unto me according to your word. So, since that time until now, Mama Mary has participated in the salvation plan of God. Kaya marami tayong nababalitaan ng mga apparitions of Mama Mary, yung apparition at Our Lady of Lourdes, which confirmed the Immaculate Conception as a dogma. Nandiyan din yung Our Lady of Fatima, Our Lady of Guadalupe, ang feast day ng Our Lady of Guadalupe sa December 12. And yung mga iba pang mga apparitions niya sa Akita, Japan, sa Medjugorje, ang message is always the same. The message is, do whatever He tells you. If you are reading the Bible, sinasabi, isa lang ang sinabi ni Mama Mary na isang linya doon, do whatever He tells you. Kung anong gusto ng Panginoon, gawin natin. Yun ang laging mensahe niya. Conversion, go back to God, magbalik loob tayo sa Panginoon. Because sabi nga, the easiest way to heaven is through Mama Mary. Alam natin na si Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through Jesus. But we, if we want to come close to Jesus, the easiest way, go to His mother, Mama Mary. Ngayon, matindi ang labanan ngayon. It is the power of the evil versus the power of the children of light. Ito yung naglalaban lagi ngayon. And sabi nga eh, if we are for the serpent, then we are against Mary. If we are for Mary, then we are against the serpent. Doon sa Genesis, ipinakita doon yung labanan na magkakaroon ng laban talaga versus evil and the offspring of the woman. Sabi sa reading kanina kapag nung nagmas tayo, sabi ni God, I will put enmity between you and the woman. Sabi niya sa ahas. Because yung ahas has deceived Eve. And nasira yung plano ni God para sa mga tao, pero hindi pwedeng panalo ang demonyo doon. So, God made a way to plan another way to save man because of the fall of Adam and Eve. And because of what happened, God cursed the snake, the serpent, Satan, the evil one. Sabi niya, I will put enmity between you and the woman. Forever na magkalaban na. Enmity means they will never reconcile. Hindi pwedeng mag-reconcile. Yung anak ni Mama Mary, who is Jesus Christ, and the devil. And sabi ni God, her offspring and your offspring will forever be enemies. So this is the way. Kaya nga yung ahas, kapag makikita natin Immaculate Conception, yung si Mama Mary, inaapakan niya yung ulo ng ahas. Huh? Inaapakan niya yung ulo ng ahas. And the victory over the devil will come through Mary. And alam natin na si Mama Mary is also like us. She was a human being like us without any power, but she was chosen to be the vessel of Jesus Christ so that Jesus will come here. Kaya ang panalo natin, mga kapatid, is through Mama Mary. When the devil is attacking us, let us go to Mama Mary. Because Mama Mary's joy is to bring us to Jesus Christ. And the joy of Jesus, ang joy ni Jesus ay madala sa atin through Mama Mary, ang mga mahal niya. Kasi sabi ni God, ang plano ni God is that not even one of us should be lost in hell. Walang dapat mawala. Kaya ngayon, ang power of the evil one is so strong. When you look around, makikita natin yung power of the evil one. Especially now that yung RH bill pa na napakainit na usapan ngayon, eh, para sa mga iba, wala lang yon. But for those who are really praying a lot, ang linaw na makikita natin that it is an evil bill. Malinaw na it is unti-unting pumapasok sa kultura ng Pilipino, itong evil, the evil ways. And we cannot allow that to happen. That's why the church is in the forefront para labanan ito. At tayo, ang may tutulong natin dito is prayer. We will storm heaven with prayers through Mama Mary. Kaya, sa lahat ng mga dinaanan ng mga apparitions, sa mga hindi naniniwala sa apparition of the message of Mary, after that, nagkakaroon ng catastrophe. Because they have not listened to what Mama Mary has said. Do whatever He tells you. So, my dear friends, ito po yung message ng Immaculate Conception sa atin, that hopefully, as Christmas is coming, we also have this purity to receive Jesus Christ in our hearts. And so that we can share Jesus to others. Tulad ni Mama Mary, na naging vessel ng pagdating ni Jesus Cristo sa atin din, na maging we look to Mama Mary kasi siya yung model. She is the model of all the saints, of all who wants to be close to Jesus. Siya yung modelo. She is a model of virtue, a model of the missions, she is the model of the saints. Ang dami nating matututunan sa virtue ni Mama Mary. So, my dear friends, this is our way of saying thank you to Mama Mary. And we continue to ask her for the mantle of protection, especially to the families. For the family that prays together, stays together. Amen.